Welcome, everybody, to Scotch and Smoke Rings, episode 55. Today we are drinking Glenfiddich, a 15-year-old bottle of Scotch whiskey. I love this sound. Cheers, gentlemen. And today we are going to be smoking this. It's called Fine Premium Tobacco, Cuban Legacy, K. Hansotia and Company, A Century of Tradition. Here's a screenshot from the movie. I have been working hard. This is a finished version. Well, except for this, I'm not going to go into that. But it says the world's largest pecan pie. As you probably guessed, pecan pie has an integral role into this episode. Here is our very talented bald overalls wearing guy. What is he doing? What is his role in this epic adventure? The secret I keeps it. And these guys, Staghorn and Oxhorn, are standing here doing something violent. They're swinging their arms very wildly. Are they throwing something? Are they blowing kisses? Are they hitting somebody? Who knows? I know, but you don't. And I'm going to keep it that way until the movie is released. So, does your cat have any weird habits? Asks Cat's Eye Angie. Yeah, he can open doors. It's fairly frustrating. I'll close my door to be working on a movie or something. And then all of a sudden I'll hear, clack, 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 clack. And then the door will swing open because the cat has been jumping up and trying to put all of his weight on the latch to swing it open. It's a smart cat. Wah? Who's Justin Bieber? I guess you're talking about people I don't even know. I just blew 11 smoke rings, says Halon. Yeah, okay. Pixar didn't happen, right? I do it on video every week. I sit in front of the world unashamed of my smoke rings, pleased to be judged by the masses for my smoke rings. And to date, I have only been able to blow 9 consecutively. Would you like me to try? Are you guys wanting me to go for 10? Says New Horty. You can do it. Go Oxhorn. Try and get more than 10. Okay. All right. 10 smoke rings. Think I can do it? All right. We're going to try it. With you guys cheering me on, I think we can do this. Sorry, I got distracted. I just lost my ash on my keyboard. Right into the ashtray. Check it out. Right into the ashtray. Look at that. Ah, Pixar didn't happen. Okay, here it is. See that lump of ash sitting on the bottom? That's not from the previous cigars. That was from this. All right, 10 smoke rings. Let's try this. Nine. Nine. Well, you know what? I'm thinking that there's a theme going on here. The theme, I think, is that my mouth is just not large enough to accommodate smoke to feed 10 smoke rings. Can we get married in suspenders, says Kirky Bobs. You and your fiance want to get married in suspenders? I think that's awesome. Record it, send me a video, and I will do my best to promote it, because that would be pretty epic, you know, getting your wife to agree to that. I mean, most wives like wedding dresses, that tends to be more traditional. But if you can get her to wear suspenders instead, you have some amazing powers. So, go for it. Marcus Jacques Gudin Mockstrom on Facebook says, Oxhorn, have you ever been really drunk by your scotch? No, I have never been really drunk to scotch. What kind of car do you drive? Asks Windhorn. I'm not gonna tell you what kind of car I drive. It's okay, it's got 4 wheels. It consumes petrol, aka gasoline to us Americans. It's white, I'll give you that. The color is white. That's as much as you need to know. Scient on Twitter says, I'm not sure if I'm doing this right, but could you go through step by step how to blow a smoke ring? Sure, there are a number of different ways. I've done this on the program before, but I'll do it again for you guys. And then the third way, which I've never mastered, is actually flicking your cheek. Some people do it that way. I've never been able to do it that way. I'll try right now. Hey, I did a few. That's cool. That's neat. I'll have to try that some more later. Delanish on Twitter says, if you could, would you drive a horse and buggy? Yes, I would. Glenn Christian Rasmussen says, Brandon, do a little twist. You want me to do a twist? How was that? Please check my Facebook comment. My name is Augie Daniels. My wife and I need some scotch advice. The question covers it, says Augie M. Daniels. Wow. Okay, so I'm getting a comment on one social network that's directing me to a completely different social network. Now I've got to hunt through a bunch of posts to find one by Augie M. Daniels. Okay, Augie Daniels, there you go. Hey Ox, I have a 17-year-old bottle of scotch that my wife received from her father as an anniversary gift, but we're not too savvy on anything more expensive than a cheap bottle of wine. Any tips for maximizing our first scotch experience? Okay, so the rule of thumb when it comes to wine is you have the wine connoisseur, the person who loves wine, he's a wine aficionado, this is what he does. The wines that are more highly recommended by the wine aficionado tend to be wines least popular with the masses, and here's why. A lot of the popular wines are very sweet, and people tend to just like sweetness. They equate sweetness with goodness. However, an aficionado really likes the dry wines, and they have distinct little nuances and flavors, and so they'll rate a bottle of wine to be like a 10-star bottle of wine. And then the average person will sit down to drink it and go, ah, man, I prefer the $10 bottle of wine. It's similar with scotch. So if you buy the cheaper scotches, it's going to be harsher. It's going to be more acrid. And if you pour some, you'll enjoy it, but it'll be like, whew, you know, you're kind of, whew. However, if you get some of the more expensive bottles, like Glenfiddich, this one that I have here, it has that too, not to the same extent, and yet it has other nuances that you have to train yourself to enjoy. Like this one has a sort of peaty dirt flavor, and I know that doesn't sound good, but I guess the thing that's nice about it is that you drink it and you remind yourself of a pleasant earth smell. Lewis described it as, what was it? It was the Four Loves. He was talking about you walk past something and the scent hits you and you immediately love it. It's not a need love. It's the sort of love that just hits you out of the blue. You didn't know what you were missing until you had that sensation and suddenly you love it and you appreciate it in and of itself. That's the kind of thing with the flavor you get with a certain kind of scotch. You won't miss it if you buy a cheaper brand, but if you buy a more expensive brand and you suddenly get it, you'll really appreciate it for what it is. I think I kind of went on a digression there. Sorry, paying attention to your comments. Play the penny whistle. Could you please play the penny whistle? Brandon, I want to hear the great Kodo. Play your penny whistle. Would you play your penny whistle? All right, you want me to play the penny whistle? Okay. If I can find it. Where did I put it last week? Oh, here it is. I can do a sad one. Oh, here's one that you Final Fantasy geeks might recognize. Now, many people correctly say that you're not supposed to light a cigar or your pipe with a lighter. And this is true, because regular lighters have a certain sort of fuel in them that, when they burn, imparts an inferior taste to your cigar or your pipe. However, I'm using a specific kind of fuel for this lighter. Here it is. It's called Vector, and it's quintuplets filtered 5 times. It's very heavily filtered butane, and so it does not impart that nasty taste. Pandora says, Ox, have you ever thought of having a show on G4? Hey, that would be awesome. If you know anyone at G4, let them know that I have a not insubstantial audience here at oxhorn.com. Have you ever been recognized in public, asks Chris. Yes. Okay, so at BlizzCon, I'm recognized in public all the time because that's BlizzCon. So that doesn't count. Aside from BlizzCon, I've been recognized in public 3 times. Once I was in Berkeley, California, I was walking home from work, and this French guy stops me on the sidewalk, and he's like, Oxhorn? And I'm like, oh, crap. And I turn around, and I'm like, hey, and he's speaking in this really thick French accent. He's like, oh, I watch you in France all the time. I love your machinima. I'm friends with Oli Biff, and blah, blah, blah. I just appreciate your machinima. What's a French dude doing in Berkeley, California? And I'm like, okay, cool. I shook his hand. He was a really nice guy. And then about a year ago, I was at Safeway, the nearby Safeway, near my house, actually, buying something. I think it was fairly embarrassing. I was buying toilet paper. That's right. I was in line at Safeway with a big thing of toilet paper buying it, and the woman in line next to me says, Oxhorn? And I'm like, I have toilet paper in my, hi, good to meet you. And she was a really nice lady. It was fine. You know, she says, I'm a big fan. I watch your show. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. She was sweet. She didn't even mention the toilet paper. I just grabbed it and walked out the door. And then I was recognized one other time, but I can't recall. I think it was at an airport. I was on my way to California. No, I was on my way to Seattle from California, and I was recognized on an airport. And they actually shared the same flight with me and tried to talk with me during the flight, which was slightly awkward. Because they were like three chairs back, and I'm sitting in front of them on the flight, the three chairs back. And it was like a two-hour flight, and they're trying to talk to me. Like, we get up to the altitude where we can move around in the cabin. They're like leaning up over the chair saying, Oxhorn, blah, blah, blah. And I tried to be polite, but after a while, I just kind of wanted to read, and so I ignored them. Thank you, everybody, for coming to episode 55 of Scotch and Smokings. Hope you enjoyed it. We, of course, do this every week, 7 o'clock p.m. Pacific time here at oxhorn.com. And be sure to, as always, we say here at oxhorn.com, stay just a little bit classy.
No, 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 no!